Guys, and welcome to this new video tutorial. In this video, I will show you an easy way how you could clear all the cache files from Windows. This will allow you to delete temporary files created by Windows and by other softwares, which will help you to increase the performance of your computer. We will be doing this without any software and through a manual way. First of all, we want to open a new window, or you want to go to this PC and you want to click on Windows. We want to go here to Software Distribution, and on the next we want to click on the file called Download. Once there, Control A and click Delete. These are temporary files created by downloaded softwares and also by Windows when it's making updates, so you want to delete all of this. As you can see, it was occupying almost 2 giga and it's quite a big space, especially if you have an SSD. While it's being done, we want to click on the Windows sign plus the letter R in your keyboard in the same time, and we want to type the percentage sign TMP and again percentage sign. We are going to click OK. Please, before you proceed with clearing all the cache, make sure to save all your work and to close all open softwares, including Microsoft Office, so that you don't lose your work. So we will hold on here. And what you want to do, again, you want to select everything and click Delete. I will not be deleting now because I'm using the software for recording my screen, but you can go ahead and do that. So to delete again, you just click select everything, you press delete, and you should be able to delete everything. While it's deleting, we are going again to click on the Windows sign plus the letter R to open the run command option, and we're going to type TMP this time without the percentage sign, and we're going to click OK. Again, this is a list of another temporary files which we need also to delete. And again, make sure that all softwares in your computer are closed and that your work has been saved. So again, just click Control A, select everything, click Delete. You might be asked that you don't have the admin right, just click OK and continue. It should be deleting everything. The next step again, Windows sign, letter R in the same time, and we're going to type prefetch and we're going to click OK. We will click continue, and again you will have to delete everything. You will find the name of all these commands in the video description. So we are going again to click Control A and then click on delete. You might be again told that you don't have the admin right, or if you want to continue just click yes, and we're going again to close. The next step we are going to do the WS reset. So again, Windows sign letter R, type WS reset and click OK. And you will see this window going, and also the Windows Shop application. So you have just to be patient until everything has been done. Usually, since I'm disconnected from internet, it's not a problem. But make sure that you are connected to the internet while doing that, so it should clean everything for you. So here, once we are done, once you see the Microsoft Store app completed, just click Close. The next step, we will go to our recycle bin, click with the right button of the mouse and select empty recycle bin and click yes. This will remove all the files from the recycle bin, and then there is also two additional steps which we will need to do before we are completely done with the cache files and the temporary files in Windows. So next step, press the Windows sign and the letter E to open new window, and go to lock this PC app. Click on your local disk C and select Properties. Here we are going to click Disk Cleanup, and the disk cleanup will start. If your computer have been doing recently updates, make sure that first you install all the updates. And here we are going to go to Cleanup System Files. When Windows is doing the updates, it's downloading a certain file and keeping them as temporary to do its updates. But once the update is done to your computer, you should be able to delete those temporary files created. So here I have 325 gig free, 140 used, but I do still believe that I can get back another 5 to 10 gig because of the Windows updates, which has been done earlier. So sometimes you need to wait 1 to 3 minutes until the disk cleanup next file upload. And here you can see Windows Update Cleanup 3.3 gig and additional files. So we are going just to click OK. Make sure to deselect download files from this if you see them. So check if there is any download. If you have download file, just make sure to deselect it. So now we'll just click OK, delete files, and this should do the cleanup for our computer. While this is being done, you don't need to wait. Again, press Windows sign plus the letter R and type ipconfig/flushdns, or just copy it from my video description. You'll find it and click OK. Here you will be able to clean the temporary files of the internet. Since I'm not connected, it will not be doing the cleanup, but if you are connected to the internet, it should work for you. So for now, I will just close and we will wait until this is done. The cleanup is done. We'll just close this window. We will close this and we go back to recycle bin and check if we have anything. If the recycle bin is empty, that's good. If not, then you can just click ahead and click empty recycle bin. And with this way, you will have cleaned your computer. I hope this video tutorial was helpful to you guys. If you are still in need of help or assistance, you can always write us an email or just leave a comment below and we will assist you. If you'd like to encourage us, you can always press like if you find this video useful, and you can share with your friends if you find that they might make use of it. And you can always subscribe to get our latest videos. Thank you for watching and talk to you soon in a new video tutorial.